Tusky Supermarket, once the largest supermarket chain in Kenya, has a fascinating history of humble beginnings, rapid growth, and eventual decline. The journey of Tusky's is a remarkable tale of ambition, innovation, and challenges that offers value lessons for the retail industry in Kenya. The story of Tusky's began in the 1980s with Mr. Joram Kamau, a visionary businessman from Nakuru, Kenya. Armed with a humble background and modest academic credentials, Kamau's retail career started as a shop assistant at his father's Gateway General Stores. In 1983, with the entrepreneurial spirit driving him, Kamau sold his prized bull to raise capital and founded Magic Shop, a small mattress store in Rongai Township, Nakuru District. Kamau's eldest son, John Kago Mukuha, joined the family business as a shop hand, assisting his father and learning the ropes of retail. Inspired by the trading prowess of his Asian European friends, Mukuha was determined to revolutionize the retail trade in Kenya. Under his guidance, Magic Shop thrived and expanded into Nakuru Town, becoming Magic Superstores. By 1990, the first branch of Tusker Mattresses Limited was established in Nairobi, the capital city of Kenya. The 1900s and early 2000s marked a period of significant expansion for Tusky's. The Kamau family merged Magic Superstores and Tusker Mattresses Limited to form Tusky's Supermarket under Mukuha's leadership. The company adopted innovative retail concepts and began expanding its footprint across Kenya and Uganda. Tusky's was the first retail chain in Kenya to introduce in-store fresh food sales, including milk dispensers, butcheries, bakeries, and local food. This innovation attracted a wide customer base and set new standards for the industry. The supermarket chain committed to providing quality products and affordable prices resonated with low-middle-income households in Kenya. At its peak, Tusky's operated over 60 outlets in Kenya and Uganda. It employed more than 6,000 people and served over 10 million customers monthly. The supermarket chain became a household name and a symbol of modern retail in East Africa. Its commitment to customer service, innovation, and community support and Tusky's numerous accolades, including the Brand of a Year Award in 2017 and recognition of Best Electronics Partner in East and Central Africa by Samsung. So Tusky's has been a major giant in the retail industry in Kenya. Despite its success, Tusky's was plagued by internal challenges that foreshadowed its downfall. Family disputes over control and strategic direction led to inconsistent management decisions. The Kamau siblings, who took over after their father's passing, struggled to maintain a unified vision for the company. The lack of clear corporate management structures exacerbated these issues. Tusky's aggressive expansion was largely financed through supplier debt. While the supermarket chain initially thrived in a growing retail market, its reliance on credit proved unsustainable. By 2017, supplier debt levels had reached crisis proportions, and Tusky's found itself unable to meet its financial obligations. Attempts to secure investment and implement turnaround strategies failed terribly. The company's efforts to attract investors and implement savior schemes such as franchising plans and listing on the Nairobi Securities Exchange were unsuccessful. Poor governance and financial reporting further deterred potential investors. As Tuskys grappled with internal issues, it faced competition from both local and international retailers. New entrants like Naivas, Carrefour, Quickmart capitalized on Tuskys' weaknesses, offering better managed operations and more appealing shopping experiences. The arrival of international players like Carrefour highlighted the fragility of Kenya's retail sector. The COVID-19 pandemic dealt a financial blow to Tuskys, exacerbating its financial troubles and leading to store closures. The economic downturn and reduced consumer spending put additional strain on the already weakened company. By 2021, Tuskys was insolvent with mounting debts and increasing pressure from creditors. The once mighty supermarket chain closed its doors, leaving a significant gap in the markets. The collapse of Tuskys, along with Nakumat and Uchumi, understood the vulnerabilities in Kenya's retail and challenges of overexpansion. So Tuskys was once a thriving supermarket that it was unshakable. It was a big elephant in the room, you understand? So the siblings, the children of the founder are the ones who were not prepared to make sure that this supermarket giant can continue to thrive to the end. Even if they are not there, the supermarket should have continued to live beyond them. So Tuskys has been a major player in this in Kenya. It had employed a lot of people, and it was once a major backbone in the retail sector after the collapse of the giant Nakumat. And so I think we will be looking about the rise and fall of Uchumi supermarkets and the rise and fall of Nakumat. And those three supermarkets were giants, and if the management had managed well the supermarkets, I believe we will be having a lot of employment opportunities, a lot of suppliers will be. If you have a lot of suppliers, it means you have a market base, you have the facilities, the infrastructure. It would mean that we will have more employment opportunities for our people. And we have to see how we can prevent such kind of things happening again in the future. Because Uchumi was once the pride of this country, Uchumi supermarket. It was a government supermarket, and Tuskys was a private, but it was also the pride of the Republic of Kenya, as well as Nakumat supermarkets. So we hope that in the future we learn from these lessons of Tuskys, Uchumi and Nakumat, and then we can rectify so that our country's enterprises will not go like that. So the rise and fall of Tuskys supermarket is a cautionary tale of how rapid growth, if not managed well, can lead to a downfall. It highlights the importance of sound corporate governance, financial discipline, and adaptability in the ever-evolving retail sector. So the collapse of this giant, it was very bad because a lot of households lost the way of their what they were earning so that they can survive. And so a lot of suppliers also did not have where to supply their things. So despite its collapse, Tusky's legacy in the Kenyan retail sector remains. It paved the way for modern supermarkets and set a benchmark for consumer service and product variety. The story serves as both inspiration and a lesson for future entrepreneurs in the region. So thank you guys. In case you are new here, kindly subscribe to this channel and make sure that you hit the notification bell. Subscribe to our channel to support us. We'll bring you more content, more historical content, more informational content. We are here to give out the real information that our country needs, our stories, everything that is there. So subscribe to our channel and like. Just make sure that's the only way you can support this channel. And we hope you enjoyed the video. You can kindly also share it if you don't mind. We love you guys. So thank you and see you guys in the next video.